Hi students, good morning everybody. How are you all? I hope you are fine and also you are taking care of this coronavirus. So everybody take care of your health and stay home, stay safe. Today we are going to discuss about whole numbers. Dear students, you are aware of some numbers. So today let us see what about the whole numbers. This is C.H. Srinivas Rao from ZBHS Dabilpur comes to you with whole numbers. Are you ready children? Shall we go forward? Shall we discuss what about the whole numbers? That's good. Let us discuss, let us see. First of all, let us see one activity. Can you count these tiger? I'm sorry, this is not lion, this is tiger. Can you count these tiger? How many tigers are there? See, there is only one tiger. Then see the next pictures. How many tigers are there? There are two tigers, isn't it? That's good. Next pictures, see how many tigers are there? 1, 2, 3. So there are three tigers, isn't it? Okay, in the first picture there is only one, in the second picture there are two, in the third picture there are three tigers. Next, can you count these faces? See one more activity. What is this activity? There are some faces. See, I have given some faces. Count these. 1, 2, 3. How many are there? So there are four faces. Very good counting. Count the next face. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many faces are there? There are six faces. Very good. Like that, count these faces. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many are there? There are 12 faces. Very good. Keep counting. Very good. What did you understand from this counting? See, we have counted some tiger pictures and we have counted some faces. From these countings, what did you understand? Is there any meaning of this 1, 2, 3, or 6, or 10? Why did you count like that? See, while counting things, we need the help of numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. So whenever you count some things, for example, your mummy asked to go to the shop and purchase some 10 eggs. You will go to the shop. The shopkeeper will give you eggs. Obviously, you will count the eggs. How many eggs? Why? Because mummy told you to bring 10 eggs. So you have to count, no? You will count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like that you will count and you will see whether he is given, he gave 10 eggs or not. Like that, for everything while counting. If you come to school, while coming to school, you will count the books. What are the books are there in your bag? How many books are there? Some 10 books or 12 books, some 6 notebooks and 5 textbooks, like that. So while counting things, we need the help of numbers. Those numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So these numbers are called natural numbers. Listen carefully, dear children. What are these numbers are called? These numbers are called natural numbers. What are natural numbers? 1, starting from 1. Remember this? This is starting from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that 10, 100, 1,000,000, 1,00,000, 1 crore, any number, very, very big number. We do not know what is the last number of natural numbers, or what is the biggest number of natural numbers. Okay, that's good. Now, the set of natural numbers in the form of n. These natural numbers we will denote by a letter n. We will denote by a letter n, and is written like this. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like that within the set brackets. Like that within the set brackets. These are natural numbers. Once again, children, what are natural numbers? Natural numbers are starting from 1. Ending, we do not know. Can't define. We do not know what is the end number. But starting number we know. What is the starting number is? 1. Okay? These are natural numbers. See, so far we did not enter into the whole numbers. Just we are discussing about natural numbers only. Okay, see now. What is the least natural number? We have seen in that natural number now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. So in that what is the least number? Least natural number is 1. Okay. Next. What is the highest natural number? As I said, we do not know what is the highest natural number. So it is can't define. The highest natural number cannot be defined. That's okay. What is the successor of 5? See, successor means the next number. Successor means the next number to 5. That is 6. Next number to 5 is 6 only, no? Next number to 10 is 11. Next number to 100 is 101. That means that is the successor. That we will call it as successor. What is the predecessor of 10? What is the predecessor of 10? Predecessor means before number or previous number. What is the previous natural number to 10? Previous natural number to 10. 10 kante mundu a natural number untundi. That is 9. Isn't it? So this 9 is called the predecessor. Understood? Successor means the next number. Predecessor means previous number. This you have to understand very carefully. What is the successor of 100? Now you can easily say the successor of 100 is 101. What is the difference between any two successive natural numbers? What is the difference between any two successive natural numbers? Natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that only, no? So, for example, successive natural numbers means side by side, immediate numbers. 3, 4 are two successive natural numbers. So, what is the difference between 3 and 4? That is one only, no? Like that 99 and 100. 99 and 100 successive natural numbers. What is the difference between 100 and 99? That is one only, no? So, what is the difference between any two successive natural numbers? That is 1. Now, can you say the predecessor of 1 in natural number? This is very, very important, children. Listen carefully. Can you say the predecessor of 1 in natural numbers? In natural numbers, what is the predecessor? Predecessor means previous number of 1. What is the previous number of 1? Is there any previous number for natural number 1? What did I say? Natural numbers means starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. But before 1, what number is there? Nothing is there. Can you say the predecessor? In natural numbers only. In natural number, there is no previous number to 1. So we cannot define. It is not there. It is very important. Now, let us see the next one. What is this one? Once again, try this. What to try? You will see. Count these balls. I will give some balls. You have to count. Count. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many balls are there? There are 4. So, see. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, what is our answer? Our answer is 4. Okay? That's good. Next. How many balls are there here? Second question. Again, you will have one activity. How many balls are there here? See, you will see. Is it a ball? No. Is it a ball? No. Is it a ball? No. What did I ask you? What is the question is given? How many balls are there here? In these pictures, how many balls are there? There are no balls here. No balls are there. So, if you give the answer, no balls are, that is wrong. What did I ask? My question is, how many balls are there? How many means you have to give a number. How many balls are there here? No balls. So, in our mathematical language, we will give the answer is 0. What is this answer? 0. Because there are no balls. These are some lamps. That's all. This is a lamp stand. There are 3 lamp stands. These are not balls. So, our answer is 0. Okay? Now, if we include 0 to natural numbers, then that collection is called whole numbers. That is what our chapter is. Natural numbers means we discussed that natural numbers are starting from 1 to infinite, to any number, any big number. Whereas this 0, if you include with natural numbers, if you include 0 with natural numbers, that means starting from 0, start from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. All these are called whole numbers. So, our chapter is whole numbers. Do you understand? That is our chapter, whole numbers. So, whole numbers. See, what is the whole numbers? So, whole numbers are represented like this. How we will represent whole numbers? Our chapter is whole numbers. So, whole numbers are represented like this. How we will represent whole numbers? That is by W. Natural numbers are represented by N. That is a natural number. Whole numbers are represented by W. Natural numbers starting from 1, whereas whole numbers starting from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. Any number, any big number. We cannot define this last number. Remember, whole numbers are represented by W and starting from 0. So, this 0 is starting number. That means this is the least number, very small in whole numbers. Okay? I'll see the next one. Do this. I am giving you some questions. You have to do at home. Okay. You have to do at home. The first question. What is the smallest whole number? These are the whole numbers. In this, what is the smallest? You know it. I don't say the answer. Second one. Are all natural numbers whole numbers? All natural numbers, whole numbers. See, natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All are there in whole numbers. You have to give answer yes or no. That's all. Next, are all whole numbers natural numbers? For this also, you have to give the answer yes or no. Next, the whole number which does not have predecessor. See, in previous slide, we discussed about the natural number which does not have predecessor. Here, the whole number which does not have predecessor. I will explain once. See, for example, this is 4. What is the previous number to 4? That is 3. That is called the predecessor of 4. For 4, the next number is 5. This is called the successor. Can you see the cursor here? It is moving. This is successor. Predecessor means previous number. Successor means next number. Okay? Like that, the whole number which does not have predecessor. See, for 4, 3 is the predecessor. For 3, 2 is the predecessor. For 2, 1 is the predecessor. For 1, 0 is the predecessor. For 0, there is no predecessor. Now you could understand. I hope you understood. Okay? So, what is the whole number which does not have predecessor? What is the whole number which does not have predecessor? Yes, that is 0. Very good. Let us see the next one. What is the next one? Representation of whole numbers on number line. How to represent whole numbers? Representation of whole numbers on number line. How to represent number line? For that, we need to take one number line. See, this is the number line you have to draw with pencil on the white paper of your maths notebook. First of all, draw one line like this. Then you have to divide this line into equal parts, some equal parts, some 5 equal parts or 7 equal parts or 10 equal parts, or if your paper is very long paper, you can give 100 equal also, no problem. This is second. Then write the numbers. See the numbers. First part is 0 because whole number it is. Since it is a whole number, the first part is 0, second part is 1, third part 2, like that 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, any number you can write. You may ask, sir, 20. Yes, you can write 20. In that case, this parts you have to make less distance. Here, I gave little more distance between two numbers. If you want to write some 20 numbers, then what you have to do is, you make this distance is less. Here 0, here is 1, here is 2, here is 3, here is 4, like that you can give. Okay, that's okay. Now this is the number line, and then you have to write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. Successor of a number lies on right side and predecessor of a number lies on left side. What is this meaning? As we discussed about successor, for example 3, what is the successor? 4. Next number is the successor. So for 3, 4 is the successor. 4 is lying on the right side of 3. Right side of 3. This is important. So successor lies on right side, and predecessor, automatically you will come to know this predecessor. This is left side. For any number, this is 3. For 3, predecessor is 2. That is left side. Successor is 4. That is right side. Successor of a number lies on right side and predecessor of a number lies on left side. This is important. For example, the successor of 4 is 5, which lies on the right side. 4 and is greater than 4. right side of 4 and is greater than 4. 4. For this 4, this is the successor. This is lying on right side and greater than 4. More than 4. 4 is always greater than 5 is always greater than 4 only, no? It is more number, isn't it? Now, there is one homework for you. Try this. What is this? I am giving you now. I am sorry, I did not give you, I will give you later. Next. Addition on number line. How to add whole numbers on number line? We know 5 plus 3 that is equal to 8. Here 3 plus 4 show on number line. Now we have to show this 3 plus 4. We know that 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 only. But we have to show on number line. For this, what we have to do first? First of all, take a number line. This is a number line. And then what did I say? Make it into equal parts. Separate into equal parts. So separate. See, like this I have separated equal parts. After separating like this, we have to write the numbers. Let us write the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that, how many parts? I have given here 9 parts. Students, you can write 10, 11, 12, 13 also, no problem. Now, what we have to show? 3 plus 4. We have to add 4 to 3. That is the meaning. So what is the first number here? 3. So we have to start from 3 only. We have to start from 3. So I have started from 3 up to 4. This is one number. 3 to 4, that is one number. How many numbers we have to add? 4 numbers we have to add. That means like this, we have to go 4 steps. So what is the second step? This is 2. Now the third step, this is 3. Now the fourth step, this is fourth step. So like that, how many numbers? 4 numbers, no? So 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers added. Then what is this number is? Last one? 7. So if you add 4 to 3, then the answer, the result is 7. Like this, you have to draw with pencil. Like this, arrow marks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 arrow marks. So the answer is 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Like this, we can represent on number line. This is addition. This is addition. See, from 3, we are going right side. Why? Because addition. Addition, we have to go to the right side of the number. Okay? Now, the next one. The next one is subtraction on number line. How to subtract on number line? Again, same criteria. Take a number line. First one, take the question. Show 7 minus 3 on number line. So for this, take a number line. See, this is the number line. And then separate into parts. These are the parts. After separating the parts, take the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I like that 9 numbers I have taken. Now, the question is 7 minus 3. So start from 7. Starting is starting number only. That is okay. Start from 7. From 7, since it is a subtraction, we have to come to the left side, not right side. From 7, come to left side. Like that, how many steps you have to come? This is 3, no? So, 3 steps you have to come. Okay? Let us take the first step and second step and third step. So, 3 steps over. So, the answer is 4. From 7, 6, 5, 4. 3 steps. So, the answer is 4. So, 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. This is our answer. Like this, we can subtract on number line. This is the number line. Subtraction. Okay? Next. Multiplication. Multiplication on number line. Let us multiply. Again the same criteria. Take one question. 4 into 2 on a number line. So, take one number line. For this number line, separate into equal parts. Separating equal parts. Like this. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. Write the numbers. 9 numbers. Here, very carefully you have to understand. 4 twos. 4 times 2 number. 2 number is 4 times. That means 2, 2, 2, like that. 4 number is 2 times, 2 number is 2 number. 2 number 4 times. 4 times of 2. Okay? Here you have to start from 0. From 0 you have to start. From 0 you have to start. From 0 you have to start. Just a minute. That's okay. From 0, 4 times 2. 2 steps each one. 2 steps each one. Like that 4 times. See, for example, from 0, here is 1, here is 2. So, these 2 steps at a time you have to jump. Like this. I'll show you. See, like that. From 0 to 2. This is one part. Like that, how many times? 4 times. In each step, in each jump, how many steps must be there? 2 steps. Okay. Now the second jump. In the second jump, again 2 steps must be there. See, from here to here, 1 step. From 2 to 3. Next, from 3 to 4, another step. These 2 steps together, 1 jump. That is second. Next, third. The next, fourth. So, like that 4 times, 2 steps each. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times. That is 4 twos are. What is the answer here? It is 8. 8 is the answer. So, 4 into 2 is equal to 8. 4 into 2 is equal to 8. This is the multiplication on number line. Have you understood, children? Good. Are you listening properly? Are you listening carefully? Okay. Next one. We'll see. The next one is homework. So in this session, so far what we have discussed is whole numbers, before that natural numbers, second whole numbers, and third one how to represent whole numbers on number line, and fourth one addition, fifth one subtraction, and next one multiplication of whole numbers on number line. So in all these concepts there is a homework for you. The homework is write the whole numbers between 32 and 67. I need not say the answer. You have to write only just numbers. Which numbers which are between 32 and 67? Between 32, don't write 32 and don't write 67. Between these two numbers, there are some numbers, no? 33, 34, 35, 36, like that. Up to 66, you have to write those numbers. The second question, how many whole numbers are there between 101 and 199? Here, so many children will confuse. Please listen carefully. How many whole numbers? You have to count the whole numbers between 101 and 102, 199. How many are there? That's what you have to count. Just you have to count. If there are 10, you write 10. If there are 30, you write 30. Like that the answer. Okay? Don't write all the numbers. Just you count and write the numbers. Now the third question. Find the following using number line. See, I have shown you now addition on number line, subtraction on number line, and multiplication on number line. Like this, all the three operations, addition, subtraction, and multiplication, all these you have to draw on a number line. Okay, children, have you understood? I hope you understood. Listening properly, no? Listen properly so that you can understand very well and you will not get any doubt. So, dear students, I hope you will do well. Thank you. All the best.